Gold's Gym Flamingo Sandhill. This has been my home preparing for the 04 Arnold. Another one of Brad's gyms out here in Vegas. Run by Marcel and Sean. They're great staff here. This is the hardcore gym. Today is leg day. Right now I'm running on a two-day training, one-day-off routine. Quads and hamstrings today. Next day will be chest, calves. Take a day off, and then the following day will be back and traps. And the day after that, the fourth training day of the week will be shoulders, buys and tries. Then we rest the next day, and then we start the routine over again. So that's what I've basically been doing for this contest. What I'm going to do basically is warm up on the bike for 10 minutes or 15 minutes, and then we'll get going on some legs. So started prepping 2 weeks after the GNC show, which was November 9th. So I dieted through Thanksgiving, Christmas. And, you know, for this contest, basically what I went back to is, you know, switched over to the hardest core gym here in Vegas, which is the Sandhill and Flamingo Golds. Of course, we have a choice of many Golds, but this seems to be the place where I've done most of my training for the show. And I was actually fortunate enough to have my wife back with me training again, taking me through definitely through leg day and back day mostly. And she's kind of been hanging out and training around me and pushing me, because I had a kind of a hard time getting going for this show with some injuries that stem from, you know, the paint contest I did. Nothing major, but just aches and pains that I've been kind of nursing all the way through this training. But fortunately, my body's responded well, and I'm still, I still would say, you know, I'm not 100%, but pretty close, and feeling pretty good about, you know, the Arnold Classic coming up in 2.5 weeks, which I plan to win for the third time straight, which I have almost no doubt in my mind that I will. So thank you. access strength is gym too. Alright, let's throw a quarter on.
Two. Gotta get the butt in there. Which is all we're really trying to do now.
Yeah, we don't want to, just want to push the tissue. 2.5-3 hours of cardio a day right now, so we don't want to burn it out. Thank you. His bar doesn't turn his head. Thank you.
also had some connection to that, and it also tells you that it's not the
at this point, police have no suspects.
John Las Vegas police had a busy morning. The stolen water gun. The case began in Las Vegas
No pain. My wife's the best training partner I ever had. Girl trains harder than one of anybody. Come on. I just wonder why she doesn't sweat as bad as I do. Good job. I started this video today probably weighing 285. I'll be about 265 by the time I'm done. Give me a warm up of 120. Nursed a really pretty serious hamstring strain. First 6 weeks of this training for this contest. So I've been kind of nursing with the legs and everything. Being stuck on Smith machines to do my squats and not be able to go 100%, but I think we'll fare just fine. It's not all about heavyweight sometimes. I know people think that, but it's just all about working the muscle and feeding it. That's it.
Thank you. set. Come on now.
Give me a drop.
Yep.
Give me 100 pounds. I lose 15 pounds.
Five, six, seven, eight.
3db. Gym in New York, man. Now we stretch a little bit. Weights are done for today. I did an hour on the stair mill this morning. Back to the gym tonight between 1 and 2 o'clock in the morning for 15 minutes on the treadmill. 15 minutes on the cross trainer, half hour cardio tonight. Getting close now, I don't want to do too much. Kind of close to condition where we need to be. Wake up in the morning about 266, pushing about 271, 272 by the end of the day. Doing a high protein, moderate carb diet. Just fine tuning now, nothing crazy. We're right where we need to be. I feel that this is one of my best looks 2.5 weeks from the show, which we are right now. So I'm not gonna do anything drastic at this point. I'm gonna walk into Columbus. No carb depletion, no carb loading. Just cut a little fluid, cut a little salt. And gonna collect the checks and the Hummers and give the fans the best look at Jay Cutler they've seen, and come home and start all the promotions for O4, see what I can do for the sport of bodybuilding. And another thing, I get to eat. And then we can film the heavy training, heavy weights, off-season diet for Jay Cutler, which we'll see where that brings us. But you're gonna have to stay tuned for that. We've got a job to do here the next 2.5 weeks, and then it's my so-called Miller time. Even though I don't drink, it's still gonna be a party when it's over. Not all about weight training and eating and sleeping. You gotta take care of the body too, do the stretching, the other side. Light always helps to have someone there in the gym. Even though Kerry's not really my training partner, she trains around me and is able to be there when I need her. And with her in her school right now, 7 class a couple days a week, she's able to work into my schedule and help me with the cooking and training. But she's also the coordinator of a lot of my guest spots and taking care of the Jay Cutler mail order, which I couldn't do without her. Everyone, you know, we all need that backbone, and I have a great support team, so I'm very, very fortunate, you know, that I don't have to pay a trainer or nutritionist or whatnot. She says she's kind of doing my diet this time. We, you know, kind of eyeballing everything and taking care of business on our own this time. And I think it's going to pay off. I'm just a little hard on myself, so sometimes I tend to push a little too hard. So you need someone there to tell you when to back down a little bit, it's hips.
This is when all the crazies come out. It's even dead in Sin City, 24-hour Vegas. Only the crazy people come out this time. Set the alarm clocks, let's go. Cardio time. Every night, 2 a.m., 3 a.m., I'm in here. Something different I had to do this time to shock my body. I get up out of a dead sleep, set my alarm, come in here, do some cardio. That's always something different. Tonight I'll start with a treadmill, jump on the cross trainer, maybe get on the bike. I did stairs for an hour this morning. All over again at 8 a.m. Go home and we eat one last meal. And we get fish. And start sleeping for 4 hours. And this is how we do it. 2.5 more weeks of this. And again. Then I won't see a treadmill till July.
I think
It's about 270. So today, assuming the scales are pretty close, when we shot at 2 o'clock, I was about 270 with some clothes on also. So we're 4 meals deep from that. My weight's not fluctuating much now. I'm, like I said, waking up about 265, getting up to 270, 271. And that basically means that I'm maintaining. Maybe I'm gonna tighten up a little bit more, but it's just gonna be dragging out the water at the end now and taking home the title. You know, that's what I'm gonna do. You know, this shows, this win's gonna mean a lot to me because I worked harder than probably I've ever have for a bodybuilding show, and you know, taking a few defeats last year, you know, to Ronnie and Dexter, definitely lit a fire for me to try to achieve a different look and produce something that you know, of course, my fans and also the judges want to see. So that's what we're shooting for this year's Arnold Classic, and hopefully that, you know, that will introduce a whole nother aspect of Vegas, and it just won't be Ronnie's contest. And you know, I'm still at the advantage here, man. It's my home. This is where I live, and you know, this whole place caters to the bodybuilders. I mean, look, 24 hours. I'm gonna walk next door to Rio Tan. I'm gonna tan. Even though I have a tanning booth at home, I like to get in the tanning booth the last few weeks, even twice a day, which I tanned already at home this morning, and I'll tan again. Really helps thin the skin and create an increase in body temperature, of course, which will keep my body burning a little bit. But I gotta have that nice base tan, so when I do put the color on for the show, it's more natural, and of course that gives me an advantage to look better on stage. So I'm gonna shoot next door and hit the tanning booth for a half hour, go home, eat some fish, do it all again in the morning. Verification.
Cool. You're all set.
All right.
Head on back to bed.
Ultra bronze. Need one of these at home. They're about 30 grand. But I'm sponsored by Hex Tanning. International Tanning Systems. I got my booth at home, so I'm good. All right, that's it. Yeah, this is my my little home gym here in my garage. My last DVD, I had a little tiny treadmill out here. Now, I got the two treads, stairs, got more covers up here. So what I do is I sit here and bang away at the cardio and glance over at these covers and realize what I got to shoot for here. Look at those Arnold Classic victory trophies, winning the Arnold. Wanting to be there again, man. So I keep plugging away. This year I worked a lot more on conditioning, never really performing a lot of cardio in my routine. Sometimes going up to 3 hours a day. But as we get closer, I'm backing off a little bit because I'm basically in shape. But I lived on these stairs, put a lot of miles on these stairs last 14 weeks. And it's made a huge difference in my glute hamstring tie-in and my overall condition. Like I said, my body weight's probably down 10, 15 pounds from normal right now. But I think the condition is going to be great, you know. And most of the difference is just fluid retention that I had, so no big deal. Like I said, I want to be tight as a drum when I get to Columbus. Not have to do too much. Draw about 6 pounds of water, cutting the sodium, cutting my fluids. Nothing drastic. And take home another title. Concentrating on only the Arnold Olympia this year. And signed a great deal with Muscle Tech. And you know, they're supporting me through this contest. And I look forward to a great 04. Definitely gonna slow down my guest appearances in 05. 06 and 07. So I concentrate more on training and being home more and take care of business at home, since I have a lot of other investments and business opportunities here in Vegas going on. And of course, spend more time with my wife, because, you know, I'm 30, I'm not 20 anymore. And some things are more important in life. Now that I'm getting a little bit older. But right now, these 14 weeks is all about this contest. No world, just me, the gym, the treadmill, taking care of business. That's it.
Yeah, I forgot to tell you, baby, there's regular flavored oatmeal, just normal in those packets.
Oh, yeah.
You know, so if you run out.
Okay.
No, Tracy. Favorite meal of the day, breakfast, egg whites, mushrooms, cup of oatmeal. NitroTech shake. Cup of coffee, sugar-free Tang, a little glutamine. Right now I'm drinking about 3 gallons of sugar-free Tang a day. cut way back on my sugar now. I try to use as many whole foods as possible. Especially with this diet, no simple sugars. Just the self-tack, that's it. But no Coke like I used to have, and no more rice cakes. I had to cut all that stuff out. And take a bunch of vitamins here. Choline, cranberry, grape seed, multivitamin, mineral, vitamin B, vitamin C. Saw palmetto, calcium, magnesium, evening primrose oil, milk thistle, folic acid, vitamin E, calcium. Keeps my immune system up and recovery. Just finished an hour of cardio. Probably burned about close to 1,000 calories with those stairs and the treadmill work. But right now my diet consists basically about 3,500 to 4,000 calories a day. Basically change things up a little bit day to day depending on how my body looks. Today I woke up at 265, so my weight's stable, so probably keep the calories about 3,500 today. I basically just add a little Splenda, and I love my cinnamon. My oatmeal in the morning. I had a lot of extra water, so it fills me up a little more. When you're dieting, that's the right thing to do. I add a little water to my egg whites when I cook my egg whites. Add a lot of water to the oatmeal. It gives it more volume, so they stay a little fuller. Because I'll finish this meal and I'll feel like I never even ate. My body's like a freight train right now. But basically, I'm keeping one fat meal in a day, which is a steak. All my other meals are fish. I have some turkey. Egg whites, and then I basically have oatmeal almost every meal all day, except for a couple meals I have some turkey and rice. Ground rice, a lot of vegetables, a lot of asparagus these last couple weeks, good diuretic. Doesn't taste the best, but you know what, we don't go for taste. Meal one, here we are. Why don't you sit down and eat, bud, before your food gets cold. But the car grabs like crazy. Ticket? Was that in the last one?
day of work. Stretch my calves like this. Really stretches them out.
Thank you.
Learned a lot over the years, you know. I overtrained for a lot of years. Right now I'm just sticking to basically 9 working sets for chest. Let's go by feel at this point, you know. Just need the basics, that's it, shock the muscle and feed it. Just gonna do nothing to really train for mass at this point, you know. Show's 2.5 weeks away.
positive for chess today. That's it for today.
Meal two post train. A couple of rice, brown rice with vegetables and 12 ounces of top round steak. Always have steak for meal two, with of course brown rice and a lot of vegetables in my diet. Very, very important for me, eat a lot of vegetables, which a lot of bodybuilders do not. But the thing with me is, I do not eat out on a diet, so I haven't eaten at a restaurant in about 12 weeks since I started my diet 14 weeks out, because I weigh everything perfectly and cook it all myself to make sure that I get all the proper calories that I need. That's why I like preparing for the Arnold Classic the most out of all the shows, because I enjoy dieting through the holidays and whatnot, because there's no demand for a bodybuilder for guest appearances and whatnot most of the time in the States, so I don't have to travel as much. My schedule really slows through November, December, January, February, and then I start picking up in March again, which I start appearances week after the Arnold this year. Dog's hungry. That's Big Trace, the Airedale Terrier.
I got a picture, Mom?
Well, I got
to
get back
on the time. Over here.
I already talked to that guy.
Thanks, man. Want to get it?
That one? That one?
Yeah.
Here you go.
There's another egg. All
right, yeah. Well, he said he used to work with
him. Yeah. One more, Jay, if you don't mind. If he has time for one more.
Knock it off. What up, Jay Bird?
Hi, Jim.
Hi.
Good to see
you. How you doing?
Very, very good. Thanks.
What's going on?
That's okay.
I'm dying to be here. I know you love me.
See, we're drawing so much attention here at the Ironman Expo. We got Jim Mannion, the NPC president. Come check out what's happening with Jay Cutler and the Muscle Machines. So everyone's in town for this one. Okay, I'm gonna eat in 2 seconds once we get done with these people.
Okay, 1, 2, 3. Thanks. I accidentally
made
it. Oh, it's
not okay.
Thank you.
You're talking
about a
pot? Yeah,
here we are with the Muscle Machine, Stage and Lane Productions. Here's a man over here behind the Frantic Frog, Steve Metz. His son, little Steve over here.
Little Steve.
That's
biceps on wheels.
We're going to be getting him into Big Steve pretty soon.
So, hey, Jay, it's just a matter of time you're going to win it, man. I know it.
Thank you. But we got all the fans here checking out the car and the booth and what's happening with Jay Cutler. This is the newest thing that that we're launching in 2004. You're going to see the Muscle Machines and a lot of places and die-cast cars, and that's it, rock and roll. Here we are again, turkey and rice. I gotta take my break every 2.5 hours to eat. Pack my food, staying out here at a place with a kitchen, which we always make sure we have available so we can cook our food. Carry with us today. If this was the Arnold Expo, we may not be able to sit down and even eat. Not looking forward to that in 2 weeks, that's for sure. Dry turkey, dry rice, brown rice. 12 ounces of turkey, 1 cup of rice.
Whack, you know that.
This is nothing compared to what it usually is like.
Really?
The thing is, into my dungeon. Gold's Gym Flamingo.
Gold's Gym
Marcelli
Flamingo.
Takes care of the place over here. And Gold's Gym has been really, really good to me out here. I trained at all Gold's Gyms, but I finally found a home here. And
We like having them out here, man.
I keep everyone motivated here, and including this guy. So
that's right. good to have Jake.
When you come to town, make sure you check out Gold's Gym, Sand Hill, and Flamingo. It's the only place to train in Vegas. We're about a week from the show now. So like I said, nothing crazy, just trying to come in here. Just put some blood in the muscle. Warm up with a little bike work, which I do before every workout because of the injuries that I had. I definitely need to do the warm up now, and then we're going to start with some shoulders. Then we're going to head to some arms, some biceps, triceps, and then finish up with some abs. Then we'll hit a few poses, and we'll be done for today. So just focused on, you know, bringing in more detail now. Legs are looking pretty good. Abs. Basically, we're ready to go for the show. I'll probably be in the low 60s for the contest. I'll actually put on a few more pounds the next few days before I start my final week, which I changed my diet up. And like I said, in the finish show, probably not much change at the end, which I normally still have 10 or 15 pounds of water to lose. I'll probably only lose about 3 pounds on Friday night, and I'll be good to go on Saturday morning and win another title. So, like I said, this year my confidence level is really, really high because I feel that I'm basically where I need to be. Whereas the show, if it was today, I could walk on stage today and basically not have to do too much. And, you know, I'll get further into my diet and stuff in a separate segment of this video and explain kind of how I manipulated things and made some changes from the past to be able to come in with a drier, more polished look, but you know, actually probably at a heavier body weight because I was less than 260 at the Mr. Olympia. You know, when I was at my best in 01, when I get second to Coleman, I was about 255. So this should be my heaviest and best look that I've achieved so far in my career. And you know, it's just up to the judges and you know, how I perform that day is whether I'll take my third Arnold title and go down as history as a first three-time consecutive winner, which never has been done before. Flex has won 3 or 4 Arnolds, but not consecutively. Right now, I'm a two-time tied with him as a two-time consecutive champ. And that's it. So basically, this morning, I ate 2 meals. Did an hour on the stair mill this morning, staying with the cardio right up till I leave for the show on Wednesday. Stay with the training till Wednesday. So far we've gone through legs, chest. Now today we're doing the shoulders and arms. Finish tomorrow with back, and that will give you an in-depth look at basically my 4 weight training days. And a few odds and ends that I work to prepare for a contest. I think I'm actually the first guy that's actually shot a training DVD or video this far from the contest, but I wanted to give the viewers, you know, a little something extra special because the next one around that we'll shoot, which will probably happen before the Mr. Olympia contest, will be my off season when I'm much, much bigger and not in this kind of condition, but training for mass, heavier weights, and you know, maybe a little more intensity. You know, training for a show, a week and a half out, 2 weeks shooting a training video, you can't go all out. I mean, it's stupid to risk the injury, especially when you're a contender for the contest, so no showboat.
and that's what separates a smart bodybuilder from, you know, the guys that just go in there and try to put on a show.
How about the sheet belts, baby? That was some side laterals. Yeah. Ready to go, baby. No mistakes. Getting better by the day now. Striations. Here you go, baby. Split biceps. Peaks. Slamming the weights.
Muscle Fitness Flex.
Another one of my major sponsors.
I'm exclusive to Muscle and Fitness and Flex magazines. So, those are magazines. If you want to see Jay Cutler, you'll buy Muscle and Fitness and Flex. They're the most updated photos. Alright, last one.
Thank you. Thank you.
Abs for days. All right, little bicep. I'll warm it up. God, I only got one more week of this left. I'm already stocking my junk cabinet at home. Buying all the goodies for after the show. We're all human, man. Probably the best my arms ever looked
for a contest. Maybe.
68 today. So we'll see where I land. I should put on a little more weight this week as I back off the training intensity a little bit. Right now the plan is
Train back tomorrow. Saturday off. Leg Sunday. Back Monday. Shoulders. Arms on Tuesday. Chest on Wednesday. And I fly to Columbus on Thursday morning. Get to Columbus, have a meeting on Thursday night. Jan Tanner comes and put my spray tan on, my mist. Do the final touches for the contest on Saturday, and then Saturday at 12, it's on, pre-judging, which basically is the contest. And then I head to the muscle tech booth after pre-judging, take some photo ops for an hour, head back to the room, do some touch-up rest, go to the night show, and then the show's over by 10, and hopefully walking away with my third consecutive victory. And this DVD is going to show all the training and diet and cardio and basically all the hard work that's gone into becoming a champion.
First, and we're gonna move over to some one-arm hammer machine rows. A couple sets of pull-ups on the assisted pull-up machine, just really squeeze the back, which we're trying to do, of course, as close to the show. I'm gonna move over to some two-arm dumbbell rows on an incline bench, which I'm a huge believer in, trying to work detail into the back. I'm gonna move over to some T-bar rows. Finish off with some cables and deadlifts probably. And then we'll do some traps, just some seated dumbbell shrugs, nothing crazy. We'll already get a lot of our trap work in with our back training. And that's it. Home and rest, go back to the gym tonight about 2 a.m. Last session of cardio and off tomorrow, and then I start my final 4 days of training straight, and I head to Columbus. So, do a little warm up here on the bike. I'm weighing about 270 today, so I'm up 2 pounds from yesterday. Like I said, I'm gonna start bringing the weight up a little bit. Like I said, land who knows where, but somewhere in the 60s for a show. So, as you see, I got my my prediction hat on. I like to wear this when I train. Someone made this for me last year when they thought I was going to win the Olympia, so my buddy Val. So I said, I'll wear it, don't worry, because I'll make the prediction come true. Gonna win the Arnold first, so that's our main goal next week. A week from today, I'll be sitting in the hotel room, just counting the hours. Hopefully 110% on the money. And, all the hype will be over on Saturday when hopefully walking away with the third place. It's all about the concept, man. Nothing else, man. It's all I sit around, think about the show, think about winning, becoming the best. Of course, on to the Olympia at the end of the year. Thank you.
Muscle Tech got me these sneakers as a signing bonus when I signed with them. My own sneaker cut above.
I'm going to go to the bubble.
Picked up another sponsorship, Max Muscle Clothing. Gonna be endorsing a whole new line that's coming out. Really gonna try to launch a new new dimension in bodybuilding clothing. Or in retro style clothing. I'm gonna use my name and likeness as the backer because I wear their clothes quite a bit. Alright, that's it, baby!
Yeah.
Traps, the best thing for traps, man. It's all legs, hips, everything out of it. Can't go as heavy, but a couple warm-up sets, two or three working sets, enough to stimulate. I've been going up for about 4 or 5 plates each side, but I'm not going to really push it.
No need to now. I'm just trying to really squeeze today. Stimulate, so. Try to do some clean reps with this. I'm tired, man. That massage killed me.
Thank you. Did I have a mitt?
Yeah, Mitch.
Mitch, man.
Jose!
Here we are at the.
Get Jack! Tell Jack to come here!
San Diego Bodybuilding Show. Once again. With all my friends back here.
Yeah, we're friends.
Supporting John's show, which we guest post here every year. My last video, this was about the week after the Arnold last year. Now this is probably 2 weeks after the Arnold Classic. So, here to put on another great show. It's not raining this year, so that's a good thing.
Yeah, it is.
Because last year was raining hard. I think Barb came this year especially to oil me. Every year she comes to.
Yes. 10 people ahead of you right now. 10 people. Yeah. Overall.
Every year.
It's such a tough job. It's so hard.
That's copyright, dude. Hey, Diva, did I approve it?
It's been hard doing it.
Get out, what's the name of it? Ron, he got camera. He's in. I was down going on this.
Sure.
Can I go to Olympia?
No, he had a ticket.
No. I was at a mental institute.
Call your
Bill. Cool.
Do you need?
Hey, how's it going, man? You look like you're doing like an Arnold or something.
I put on 35 pounds.
Since the Arnold?
Yeah.
Holy shit. Than all
damn, it's been what? 5 days, man. Hmm?
It came off. So they put it back on and they frayed. So he's gonna have like a little bit of a line, they said. He'll be alright.
He competes?
Yeah, he went to Arizona last year.
That's why you shouldn't write "keep ripping" on your pictures.
Well, I signed a picture of her.
Yeah, it was one that they had taken of me.
Yeah.
Where's Victor and Jerry?
Victor, my brother.
Alright. Second last line, last
you see this guy accepted a trophy at the Arnold? Like he knew it. Goes right to the handshake. He's got the same token. Wanna go four times?
Four and five and six.
Thank you.
Yeah, he was pretty full this year.
Ain't no 1 point difference, dude.
No, I know.
I went prejudging by 6 points.
Are you doing it?
Huh? Yeah, it's the first time.
Let her have fun.
Mitch, can you see that? Yeah. You know, it's sort of like a door. What do you think?
Like a barn door.
Don't worry about it.
10:15 my ass. It was 6 minutes and then the girl just getting her filled.
Overall,
shot's getting tight.
The shoulders are a little pumped up.
Just like this now.
There you are. Just coming.
You're right out of schedule, man. I counted, there was like 38 people, and you're out in front, and we get down to about 20. Barbara, you got him right on the money, man. The one girl's, we're doing the overall now, the one girl's going to go out now and get her trophy and her overall gone, and you're in.
She's just taking a trophy.
Thanks.
And we are
back in the bag.
The first time he won a pro show was in 2000 when he won the Night of Champions. 2003, he won the Arnold Classic, and just a few weeks ago, he won the Arnold Classic again. This guy has more Humvees than most people have cars in their entire families, because that's what you get when you win the Arnold Classic. So, here he is tonight. At roughly 280 pounds, give or take a pound or two. Now let's give it up big for this guy, because he is a champion, ladies and gentlemen. Let's hear it for Jake Cutler!
The following program brought to you by TGancy.com. Tonight on VH1, Behind the Muscle, the story of Jason J, a cut above the ultimate beef Cutler.
And this will all be over in a minute.